Well, I'm Crosby Doe, and I ran across a little guidebook called A Guide to Architecture in Southern California, published by the LA County Museum of Art. And that's where I was first really exposed to the case study houses. When I took a look at that book, I said, let's forget about real estate areas, let's sell architecture. And I've been lucky to experience and share the joys of architecture for 50 years now. Case Study House number 18 was originally designed by Rodney Walker. Rodney was the bohemian of the group. He was the most independent. Interestingly, three of his houses were actually part of the case study program. I think the reason for that is that he was really utilizing materials that were the most cost effective, and he was concerned with building the property really from the ground up. So he would grade the site, he would design the house, and he would oversee building it as well. This house, its exterior is done in scored plywood, a very interesting and unique material for the time period. The challenge is because they don't make it anymore. And of course, plywood has a certain life, maybe 50, 60 years. Much of it's still here, but to get it back to the original natural plywood, it will take some special recreation of the machines that made them. There's something about the way light comes into these houses that just enlivens the spirit. And as a matter of fact, that was really probably one of the prime purposes of the case study houses, to show the potential of living better, of living your life better, indoors and outdoors and in the California environment. California living was defined as early on as healthy living indoors and outdoors, the beaches, the mountains. And that was what was promoted in the 20s, almost brought as a mantra into the 30s, 40s, and it fit right into the goals of the case study period of living indoors and outdoors and that contributing to a better, fuller life. California is one of the few places in the country where you could pretty much do that year round. There is an art value to these houses, and that's really pushing the prices nowadays. But the reality, they were built for living and for making your life a better life. The architects of the period were mostly concerned with the idea of building for the general population, not just the elites. Architecture has always been in the arts kind of the weak child, maybe because you live in them, but when we think of painting and sculpture, poetry, architecture gets the short shrift in terms of value. You know, think of the Scream selling for $110 million and the Salvador Mundi $450 million. People are kicking the tires here when we think $8 or $9 million, but this is one of the icons of the period. And therefore, they should be in strong hands with people that appreciate what they are. The sad part today is that things have progressed as they have gotten art values. It's priced the younger generation out unless they inherit wealth, and that's a big conundrum. These houses have their own personalities because they were each built for a specific period, for a specific person, or for a demonstration such as this. Each work of architecture, to live in it today, requires certain compromises. You don't have the big walk-in closets here. And it's a small house. But what they give you back in terms of everyday living is priceless, so it's a compromise worth making.